So guys, what if the F-15E is indeed coming? What if the leak that we talked about it yesterday is right? We did a video about the Su-34. Let's talk about the F-15E. What can you expect from the Strike Eagle? So let's first talk a little bit about not the history, but what the aircraft is. Then we talk about the performance comparing to some of the aircraft that we have in the game, the sensors and avionics, and last but not least, the weapons, and of course, how it is going to feel like to fight an F-15E. So the history behind it is that it was designed in the 80s to be a high-speed, long-range interdictor that can fly alone without any type of escort. So either fighters or another type of support aircraft like electronic warfare aircraft or anything like that. The F-15E was made to actually be flown alone in the battlefield, right? That's why it's basically good at everything. It's one of the perfect multi-role aircrafts, and it's very similar to the Su-34 on that regard. So the introduction of it was in 1988, and what is it actually the aircraft, right? Let's start with the performance of it. So it is a heavier F-15C, right? It's basically an F-15 that can have two persons on it, so it's based on the B's and D variants, right? And of course, because of that, to do ground striking and everything, it becomes heavier. Together with conformal fuel tanks being added and some of the other things and internal modules and stuff, it is a heavier aircraft, okay? The first thing that you have to know about this aircraft is that it is heavier than the F-15C. But to compare it to the Su-34, it is a lot less. The heavier part is a lot less than the massive weight bump that the Su-34 had. So, for example, the F-15E has around 15.6 tons empty weighted, right? Which is the weight of the Su-27, more or less, and around 3 tons heavier than an F-15C. But the thing is, the Su-34 weighs more than 22 tons empty. So it is, although heavier than an F-15C, it is not as much as comparing the Su-27 to the 34, and it is around the same weight as the Su-27, okay? Initial batches had the same engine as the C model, but later models had a power compensation in the engine, okay, to basically compensate for the extra weight. Although they don't have any other mods to increase the performance, like the canards that we talk about it on the Su-34, being overall worse than the C, but not far from it. And with the extra power, if it's added with the extra power, it will be around in the same category, okay? Without the CFTs, you have to understand that the conformal fuel tanks, you never should use it in the game normally, okay? Unless you are doing a simulator battle or something, and even then, it's not really good. The conformal fuel tanks are great for a real life purpose, but in the game, it's not really useful, okay? So at the end of the day, expect a heavier F-15, but not by much. It's not as big as the difference between the Su-27 and Su-34, okay? Then we go for the sensors and avionics, guys. The main radar, obviously, is the APG-70, a redesign of the APG-63 for a greater reliability and easier maintenance of the radar itself. It has a normal pull-stopper mechanically scanned array radar, so it's a little bit different than the Su-34's one, but it's still one of the best at the time. The technology used in this radar was used in the Super Tomcat to make the APG-71, and even in the F-18 to make the F-18C's radar, which is the APG-73, right? So people say it has around 180 kilometers of range, but I mean, it doesn't matter. It has more than 100 kilometers and it's plenty, okay? But it's a long, long looking range radar, okay? It's difficult to know because all these ranges and stuff, they're classified, right? So compared to the Su-34's one, for example, it is a normal radar instead of a PESA, but it has more range in the air-to-air, and in the air-to-ground, they will be very similar to each other, okay, in the modes. They have ground modes, right? So detect targets, map the ground, etc. They can do ground stuff. In the game, it will be probably added as a normal ground radar that can just detect tanks and ships and stuff in the ground, okay? The RWR is very, very similar to the RWR of the F-15C. I think with the EX, they got a MAWL system, but before that, I don't think so. So I'm pretty sure it's just going to be the same RWR that we see in the F-15C that we have in the game, okay? The air-to-ground capabilities, of course, are improved with the usage of pods, not only the radar, but the pods, right? So it has the ability to use the lightning pod, the lantern pod, and even some more modern ones like the sniper one that has a little bit more range and stuff. It has an upgraded cockpit as well with a larger and wider HUD, among other things to help it out the pilot. And then we talk about the weapon systems. Of course, we start with the cannon. It is still the good old Vulcan M61 20mm, 500 rounds, and it has the same good old pylons as well. The 8 pylons are technically the 10 pylons, because technically the wing pylons are 3 pylons each, technically. But depending on what you're gonna put there, right? So basically, it's the same idea of the F-15C. The thing is that these pylons are stronger and they can carry more stuff. That's one of the reasons why the F-15E is heavier, if I'm not mistaken, with the fuselage and stuff. So for the air-to-air, it is the same as always. AIM-9s with the M variant probably being added. The AIM-7s with the M variant being added, probably. And then obviously the AIM-120s as well. From the get-go, the F-15E already could fire AIM-120s. So I expect, it entered in service in 1988. So it was along the same time where the AIM-120s started to be, you know, in tiny numbers used in some squadrons in the same year, if I'm not mistaken, or around that same era. So from the get-go, we will probably have the AIM-120, probably because it is what we have in the game, the AIM-120A. For air-to-ground, this is where it's really, really different from the other F-15s, right? For air-to-ground non-guided, it has this like same good old series of bombs and rockets and everything. So Mark 80s, for example, high drag, low drag, snake eyes, you know, everything. Of course, it can carry a lot more of them. For example, it can carry 15 of these Mark 82s. I don't even think some of these F-15s can carry the Mark 82, but still, it can carry like 15 Mark 82s plus the 8 missiles. So it's very much a multi-role aircraft, okay? Of course, Mark 20 Rockeye cluster bombs that we still don't have in the game, but I feel like we're gonna have. And probably rockets. I couldn't confirm if they ever used any type of rocket, but probably some form of unguided rocket as well, napalm, all the other stuff that everybody loves in the game, right? For the guided stuff is where I think is really makes it up for the difference that I was talking about in the air-to-ground role, right? Because you can all use all the paveways, and of course with the pods, you can guide them, you know, in a way better way. So the GBU 12, 10, 24, 27, and 28, JDAMs 31, 38, Mavericks, yes, you can use Mavericks, so that's good. The AGM 130, which is a rocket-powered GBU 15, that is the TV-guided bomb, also, of course, the GBU 15 itself, so we can use TV-guided bombs and technically a missile that is a bomb at the same time. And the AGM-154, for example, which is a glide GPS and INS guided bomb, right? So it's kind of like a cruise missile without the power, basically, okay? And there are other weapons out there, but some of them we don't have in the game. So what should you expect from the aircraft overall? You know, a heavier F-15, that's the major thing, but with a lot more capabilities in the air-to-ground role. Very similar to the Su-34 in objective. Comparing the two, the F-15E will be lighter and with a higher thrust weight, way higher, which means that it will be the best aircraft overall for performance. With the Su-34 having more abilities like doing anti-ship or anti-radiation missions that we don't have pretty much in the game, so it won't matter too much. The Israelis can have one too, being the F-15I, right? With some minor changes to the ground modes of the radars and other minor things of export, you know, downgrades and stuff. But yeah, in a general sense, the Israelis can have one of these too, okay? So think about these aircraft as probably one of the most perfect aircraft. Remember, guys, the more we go into the future, the less dogfights are preeminent in the battlefield. So an aircraft such as this is the perfect aircraft. It will have a better radar than the F-15Cs. It will be able to carry a lot better air-to-ground capability. So it is the aircraft that it's perfect for a ground battle, but it's still very much able to do a lot of things in the air battles as well. It's more limited to ground missions, but and specific missions, the SU-34, as I said, has a little bit more abilities, specific abilities, and the usage of larger missiles and stuff, but it is a larger aircraft, it is a heavier aircraft, so it has a price to pay, the SU-34, of doing these types of missions as well. So they're very interesting and they are perfect to be added in the same patch together. So hopefully they are indeed added in this patch. I see you guys on the next one, and this is what you should expect from the F-15E Strike Eagle. See you guys on the next one. Make sure to subscribe, click the like button, comment down below what do you think the F-15E will be like, and I see you guys on the next one.